Thank you for including my NASA data in this webinar to support GLOBE student investigations with NASA data. My name is Elizabeth Joyner, and I'm the Senior Outreach Coordinator and Point of Contact for My NASA Data at NASA Langley Research Center in Hampton, Virginia. I'm proud to work with a team of educators, scientists, programmers, and more. We're all focused on the mission of providing educational communities of grades 3 through 12 access to NASA Earth Science data, as well as tools and models for data analysis. The goal of today's session is to introduce you to MyNASA Data's Earth System Data Explorer, a data visualization tool. I will demonstrate to you how you can identify and explore NASA data related to student GLOBE campaigns and projects. I'll also model how to use the Earth System Data Explorer to access these NASA data in a variety of formats for further analysis. I will also provide resources to support research as well as how to connect with MyNASA data when questions arise about these data on our data visualization tool. The MyNASA Data team is excited to support students' research practices of analyzing and interpreting data. Our resources are uniquely poised to help students address all three themes for the IVSS in 2021, including the importance of exploring your local and regional areas, integrating a variety of data types to better address research questions, as well as addressing the need to use high-quality data in research. As researchers move from individually collected data to larger data sets, MyNASA Data provides access to professionally collected data through our data visualization tool known as the Earth System Data Explorer. No matter if you're using the GLOBE Observer app, individual protocols, or participating in GLOBE campaigns, MyNASA Data's Earth System Data Explorer provides NASA Earth Science data in daily, monthly, and or yearly formats, depending upon the science variable of interest. MyNASA Data affords the opportunity to integrate a variety of data in the pursuit of science. We are proud to offer students and teachers a variety of data to choose from, depending upon the scientific area of interest. Provided here are the numbers of supporting data sets for each of the campaigns or apps. Researchers may ask, why would I wish to use NASA datasets rather than focusing solely on GLOBE data? The answer is clear and includes, but not limited to, the following rationale. When researchers compare GLOBE data to NASA and other agency professionally collected data, they are afforded opportunities to identify a baseline to compare their GLOBE data to. They may also identify how closely aligned their observations are to NASA sensors. In these ways, the researcher may use NASA data to promote their data quality efforts. Also, including these data in your GLOBE research offers the opportunity to explore relationships among science variables for a particular location or region. This supports the researcher's efforts of data integration. Additionally, the data sets offered in the Earth System Data Explorer provide researchers opportunities to analyze and interpret similar variables for a given region or location to better characterize patterns or trends. Okay, so have I convinced you that integrating NASA data in your GLOBE research is a good idea? Great. Let me highlight for you how to get started. On the MyNASA Data website, information is generally divided into spheres of the Earth system, that is atmosphere, biosphere, cryosphere, geosphere, which is part of the petosphere, hydrosphere, and the Earth as a system. Each of these spheres offers links that are of particular interest to our GLOBE community members like you. Click on each sphere, find the GLOBE Connections link in the drop-down menu, and then open one of the resulting pages entitled Protocols and Related Earth System Data Explorer, or ESDE for short, datasets for that sphere. On this page, you will find access to a Google Sheet that provides suggested datasets that support investigations using different protocols. If you need ideas for research opportunities, explore further down the page. This is a snapshot of the different offerings of this Google Sheet for each sphere. Notice at the top for atmosphere in blue. The globe protocol shown here is for aerosols. The Earth System Data Explorer provides a variety of related NASA data sets such as daily aerosol optical depth, as well as daily cloud coverage, and many more. This resource that connects protocols to NASA data is provided for each sphere. MyNASA Data also has recommended data sets that support research projects that incorporate globe protocol bundles. This resource is provided under the Earth as a System at the top of the main page next to the other spheres. Now I want to model for you how to access the Earth System Data Explorer. This is a web-based application that doesn't require any special download. You just need to type the URL shown here. In the next steps, I will show you how to locate datasets, create mapped images and line plots, as well as show how to export the data to use in a spreadsheet for further analysis. Once the Earth System Data Explorer is loaded, you will be prompted to select a dataset. To do this, you will need to select the sphere of the Earth System of interest, shown here in number 1. These data are organized by all data or featured phenomena. I recommend browsing the datasets found in the all data list. They are provided in alphabetical order, as shown here in number 2. Also, once you've clicked on the dataset of interest, select Update Plot to load these data, shown here in number 3. Now you should see a mapped image of your dataset. You may verify this by ensuring that the radial button for the latitude-longitude under Maps is selected, as shown on number 1. You may select a particular time of interest by selecting the year, month, and/or date at number 2. Don't forget to update plot at number 3 to load your data, or select the checkbox next to update plot, and this will automatically update the data for you. Next, we will use the Earth System Data Explorer to generate a line graph that shows changes of a particular science variable over time at a given latitude and longitude. First, we will select the line plot radial button. We will select time if we wish to create line graphs of our data. See number 1. Next, we will enter an area of interest using latitude and longitude in decimal degrees, shown at number 2. Then we will enter the start and end times that we're interested in visualizing, see number 3. Finally, we will update plot at number 4. Finally, the user can export the data into commonly used data formats for use with Excel, Google Sheets, etc. Number 1, to do this, first select the Save As button. Next, under Select a Data Format, select CSV, Data File Format, also known as Comma Separated Values. Save your file into your preferred location on your computer and import these into your spreadsheet applications. Voila! Now you have your own NASA data file to use for data analysis, just like NASA subject matter experts. In case you likely missed a step, have no fear. MyNASA Data has a variety of tutorials and guides to help you use this incredible tool. Don't miss our MyNASA Data YouTube channel and the step-by-step tutorial guides to do these tasks and others, like creating your own animations of NASA data. Additionally, the MyNASA Data team is always here to help. Feel free to reach out to me or my teammates using the Contact Us link on our website. It has been a real pleasure presenting this incredible tool to you to help facilitate your globe research projects. Best of luck this year.